Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. In this video, I am going to discuss with you what is multithreading in Java. Before starting, you can subscribe my YouTube channel by clicking on the link which is available at bottom right corner of this video. You can download my app TechImage that is available on Google Play. You can connect with me by following these details which are available in front of you. Now coming on to the topic, in this video, I am going to tell you what is multithreading in Java. So you can read the first point. Java makes concurrency available to the application's programmer through its API. So concurrency means you can run more than one task concurrently, or you can say simultaneously. So if you want to run more than one task simultaneously, you can apply multithreading in Java. For that purpose, Java provides APIs. APIs means application programmer interface, or you can say predefined library. So with the help of this predefined library, you can apply multithreading in Java. Second point says the programmer specifies that applications contain threads of execution, where each thread designates a portion of a program that may execute concurrently with other threads. This capability called multithreading gives the Java programmer powerful capabilities which are not available in the core C and C++ languages on which Java is based. So I hope you have understood what multithreading is. It simply means you can run more than one task or subprograms simultaneously. A multi-threaded program contains two or more parts that can run concurrently. Each part of such a program is called a thread, and each thread defines a separate path of execution. So multi-threading is a specialized form of multitasking. Now you can understand with this diagram the life cycle of a thread. In this diagram, there are total 5 blocks: new, runnable, waiting, timed waiting, and terminated. So in further slides, I will be explaining all these blocks so that you can understand this life cycle of a thread. So first point is new thread. So a new thread begins its life cycle in the new state. It remains in this state until the program starts the thread, which places the thread in the runnable state. A thread in this state is considered to be executing its task. Second is waiting state. So it means sometimes a thread transitions to the waiting state while the thread waits for another thread to perform a task. Once in this state, a thread transitions back to the runnable state only when another thread signals the waiting thread to continue execution. So if any resource is not available for a particular thread, then it has to wait for some time duration so that it can acquire that resources for a process. Third one is timed waiting. So it says a runnable thread can enter the timed waiting state for a specified interval of time. So it is different with waiting state, because in waiting state there is no time boundation, but in case of timed waiting there is a specified time of interval available. Second point says a thread in this state transitions back to the runnable state when that time interval expires or when the event it is waiting for occurs. Timed waiting threads cannot use a processor even if one is available. A thread can transition to the timed waiting state if it is provided an optional wait interval when it is waiting for another thread to perform a task. Such a thread will return to the runnable state when it is signaled by another thread or when the timed interval expires, whichever comes first. So in case of waiting state, there is no time boundation, but in case of timed waiting, there is a time limit available, according to which transition between runnable and timed waiting state takes place. Next one is terminated state. So a runnable thread enters the terminated state when it completes its task or otherwise terminates otherwise because perhaps due to an error condition. So friends, I hope you have understood all the blocks. New means initial stage of a thread. From new to runnable state, for execution purpose, we can transfer execution. And from runnable state, it can transfer to waiting state, it can transfer to timed waiting state, and it can transfer to terminated state. So runnable state belongs to the execution of the thread, and all other parts or all other blocks defines other states. So with the help of this life cycle of a thread, you can understand different scenarios of a thread which are available in multi-threading in Java. So if you want to learn about working of multi-threading in Java, you can watch other videos which are available in this playlist. Thank you for watching this video.